Hi, today we're gonna give IDs to our items, and after we pick them up, add them to a list of collected items we are going to create too. This is the beginning of the equipment system. First of all, we need more data about our items, so let's click on the plant and let's open up item data script. Here, let's add a new public integer called item ID because we want to know what item we are clicking at, and another one called required item ID because we want to know if we need any other items in our equipment before we can pick up this one. It looks like something important, so we better move it to the top. Now in Click Manager, let's go to item function and call here a new function called try getting item. It will be a private void because we don't need to call it from the outside. And here we will decide if we get this item or not, so let's use the item as an argument. And we will grab a item.requiredItemID and check if it's equal to -1. That's our special condition for items that don't require any other items to be picked up before them. And for now, let's simply write a debug.log here, which will give us a message through Unity's console. And we are back in Unity. Let's click on a plant, let's leave its item ID as 0, that's our first item, so that's okay. And set required item ID to -1 because we don't need any other items to pick up this plant. Now as we hit play and click on the plant, we can see this message, so everything is fine. Now we need a possibility to store items that we've collected and to look for a given required item ID in the equipment. And of course, in the future, we will also display those items in equipment and maybe display the names of those items. But for now, let's concentrate on storing IDs. Let's click on our main camera and here let's add a new script, which will be Game Manager. And as you can see, we have this fancy icon because this name is pretty popular. Anyway, we don't need anything from that, and let's create a public static list of integers called collected items. It's public because we need a little bit nasty, but most importantly, easy way for accessing this list. It's static because there is only one list like that in the whole game. And it's a list, not an array or something, because we need to easily add new elements there or remove them. And to make it work, first we need to initialize it. Let's do it with new list of integers and brackets after that. Now let's go to Click Manager and let's add a new item to our list. It will be gameManager.collectedItems.add, and in brackets we will add item.itemid. This line grabs a number which is described as an item ID of an item we click at and adds it to the list of integers we've just created. It will stay there until we remove it manually or restart the game. Now let's use OR operator and let's add a new condition. We'll need to check if our collected items contains required item ID. And what all of that does is, as we click on an item, we get it if it doesn't require any other items or if our collected items list contains required item ID. Then we simply add its item ID to our collected items list, and we will be able to use it in the future. It's a good idea to add some curly brackets and write a debug.log telling us that we have collected something. Now we are going to enter the play mode and check out if it works. Yeah, it does, but we can't see many changes there. But it works. To fully test it, we need to change this required item ID to something else than minus one. Now nothing happens, so it's great. We don't get a message that we've collected this item because we can't do it. Now we may go back to minus one with this required item ID, and it turns out we have a pretty solid base for the equipment system. That's also a good time to have a break, because we did a good job. In the next episode we are going to move the player smoothly. But for now, have a good day and see you soon!